Okay, so I have connected the Lexicon now to the mixer, and the orange wire, orange cable, is the auxiliary send, or the FX send. That's the amount sent on this row right here. So this is the computer input, and I'm sending it to the effects. None of the other ones are being sent. And so that'll go out the orange wire and the mono into the back of the Lexicon in the rear mono input. And then the two Lexicon stereo outputs will go out and come back into what's called the return, or the, what do you call it here? They call it the stereo aux return. So sometimes people say aux, sometimes they say effects. It's a send and a return as a general term for it. So it's a mono send and a stereo return. The Lexicon will take the mono signal and apply some effects to it and bring it back here. We're going to send the Lexicon anything from any track by this amount, and then take the return and mix it into the output with this button here, this knob here. So I have the a piano set up. It sounds like this. Okay, a nice stereo piano. And now, let me hook the... okay. Oh, before I get into that, let me talk a little bit about the kinds of inputs and outputs. Okay, here's a whole bunch here. Here's the headphone adapter thing. So when you have a mini pin like this, headphone mini pin, you plug it in here to get an RCA type jack. So that will typically, let's see, it's hard to use two hands here. All right, so this will usually go into the phone jack, and you'll plug in the mini jacks for it. But there can be all sorts of other kind of inputs you'll need. The most common input and output is the RCA type. I mean, that's not RCA. I'm sorry. It's quarter inch type. And the quarter inch jacks look like this. Okay, they're the most common type. All of these are quarter inch jacks. There are two kinds. This is usually just called a patch cable, or a tip sleeve connector. TS, tip and sleeve. The tip has the signal, the sleeve's the ground. The other kind looks like this. It's tip ring sleeve, TRS. It also has a single signal, but something like a guitar would plug into this, and the positive signal from the guitar gets sent here. That gets reversed, and the negative is sent in the ring, and then the ground is here. Then at the other end, the negative gets subtracted from the positive, which adds together. A negative times a negative is a positive. So the two signals add together, it's twice as loud. But any hum or noise picked up along the cable is common to both tip and ring, and it'll be subtracted out. So they're quieter. So usually, these are called instrument connectors, TRS, or instruments. Guitars use them, and things like that. They're the most general connectors. Almost, they're also called balanced, because the tip and the ring are balanced. So under the mixer, you'll see bal or unbal. That means you can use either type, balanced or unbalanced. It'll accept them both. So anyway, I've hooked up the Lexicon with balanced connectors, and there's all sorts of adapters for getting to and from the various types. Okay, now, the sound is a piano. And I have it set up so that the lexicon is mixed, the input is pretty high, dry, the mix for the processor 1 and 2 are both wet. So if I look at the send level here and hit a note, you'll see the lexicon gets about a minus 12. That's kind of high. I could probably bring the effects back, but you do that by ear. So that's a good level here. It's not clipping. It's in the right range. And we can't turn this up any higher. This knob controls the mix of processor 1. To the left, nothing comes out of processor 1. Just the signal you send to the lexicon, that orange wire. So the orange wire will come in the back, and the blue and green will have that same signal unchanged. When you spin it to the right, then the whatever effect is in processor 1 will get mixed in with that dry signal. And when you go all the way, all you're getting is the lexicon effect out. None of the original signal will appear, just the effect. And that's what we want, because we're going to use the mixer to control the amount of the original signal. And then mix two the same way. Both of them full wet. We want to use routing 2 for this. You can look up what the routings are. Okay, and what I've done is pick a chorus effect for an flanger for processor 1 and a phaser for processor 2. And I've set up the phaser and chorus effect. And the return is off. So what's happening here is the lexicon's being sent this signal. These other tracks are not sending anything into the lexicon. They're all the way off. So this track is from the computer, and it's sending to the lexicon. Then whatever the lexicon does, it's being sent back, and it's controlled by this FX or aux return. Okay, so let me play a little bit now. So we put this here so you can see things. Okay, I think you can see everything, maybe like that. Okay, you don't need to see the lexicon, because I'm not going to change anything there, just here. Okay, so when I hit a note on the piano, then now let's turn up the lexicon input. So there you hear the phaser effect. Turn it off, nothing. Just a regular piano effect. Turn the return up. That's pretty extreme. Okay. Now let's try a delay. I'm going to pick, let's turn the effect down. And I'll take for effect 1, let's pick a Pong delay. And for effect 2, let's pick the reverse delay. That's kind of weird. All right, and let's see what happens. I'm not sure the delays are set for anything important. The tempo comes up, let's make it bang, 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 bang. Okay, that tempo, dang, 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 like that. I hit the notes, bang, 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 bang. And we'll play with the variation to see what happens. So here's what that sounds like. Let's take one at a time. Bypass processor 2, just leave processor 1 on. And aux return is off. So let's turn up a little bit. Okay, that's the delay. A bit noisy. Because the bypass, I think, is noisy. And then the other one's a reverse delay. Ooh, that's weird. Okay, now let's play with those a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to play with the levels and the various parameters on the lexicon. You don't need to really see these or what they do. You just do this by ear. You can read it in the manual and find out what they do and learn it. But you'll probably forget it, and then you go back and have to learn it again. So you get used to trusting your ears and trying things out. So I'm going to bypass one of them and turn on the other, play a note, and then pick the delay time that sounds right to me, and then the amount of feedback. Okay, that's a lot. That's a lot of delay and feedback. Okay, then for the reverse delay, I'm going to turn that off. Reverse delay. Okay, that's weird enough. We'll leave that in. Now we'll bring them both on. Okay, so that's a bit too weird. Let's try just a reverb now. Let's take that Pong delay. Okay, let's take the Pong delay like we had. And instead of reverse delay for 2, actually that's, yeah, then we'll take that delay and put it through a hall, like a, let's take it through a gated hall. Okay, so that's effect 2. So I'll pick, go through the effects, a gated, there, gated hall. Gated effect, Pong delay. So the Pong delay go bing bong, bing bong, back and forth, bing bong, bing bong, and then this will go, okay. Let's try it. So let's pick the Pong delay first and bypass the gate. Play a note. Wait, that's not. Oh, and then turn on the. Oh, here we go. Let's have not so many delays. Okay. Okay, so there's the delay, and that'll be going back. These, of course, the two speakers in here are very close together, so you don't get very much separation. But the Pong delays go back and forth from channel to channel. So in headphones, you'd hear it go from ear to ear. So the Pong delay, and a gated room effect. We'll turn off the Pong delay. Here's the gated room effect. So what happens is that when the note is on, it sounds like a reverb. When the note is off, it chops it off very quickly. So it's a gate. The gating means you open and close the gate. So the reverb comes in and then gets cut off. So we'll gate the reverb and then delay it. Actually, delay it and then gate it. So the number 1 would be the Pong delay. Number 2 would be the gate. Maybe I will only reverse them. So let's turn off the bypass. Let's hear what that sounds like. Okay. And if I reverse them, I'll make number 1 be the gate delay. And number two be the pawn delay. Yeah, but the same parameters. Let's see what that sounds like. So here, the first thing that happens is you get the gated reverb, and the second thing that happens is you get the pawn delay. So you can see how the two processors work in series here. Now, with different routings, you could make them work in parallel or put the left channel gets one, the right gets another. So you could, for instance, set up the mixer so that the balance sent to the left... let's see, how would you do that? I'm not sure. I'm a little tired right now and I can't think straight, but you probably could figure out how to send one thing to the left, the other thing to the right. Mono out. No, you can't do that. You only have a mono out. Okay, so all you can do is send them to both processor 1 and 2 with this sort of a setup. Okay, so now there are other ways you can connect these things. Ooh, I just noticed this EQ was... I wasn't using that channel, but these things... You should check to see that all these things are in the right place occasionally. All right, so... okay, computer. Everything looks cool there. All right, so that kind of covers... basically how to set up the mixer, how to set up the effects, and how to put everything together. I didn't use the mic yet with the Lexicon, so let's bring that in. Okay, so we'll use the same effect I have here. The mic is hooked up. We'll turn off computer, turn on the mic. Let's see, there's the mic. There's a mic. If I use my voice, and there you hear the gated room ping pong effect, and I can make a let's make a really long, have to use headphones for this. Anyway, there's my voice. Pretty much infinite delay. Okay. I think we'll call it quits here and stop.